Hello guys, good afternoon. Are you able to see the screen?
नो सर,
हाँ?
नो सर,
नो? वेट.
Now it is visible.
ओके ओके सो विल स्टार्ट विद द चैप्टर एलिमिनेशन एनहांसमेंट. से इन लास्ट क्लास व्हाट वी आर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट हाउ टू इंक्रीज द एलिमिनेशन ऑफ ऑल टॉक्सिक सब्सटेंसेस विच हैज बीन कंज्यूम बाय चॉइस और बाय चांस. ओके सो देयर वी हैव सीन वेरियस techniques or approaches in this. So like you have seen the universal one, activated charcoal, hemoperfusion, all those things, and hemodialysis, peritoneal dialysis. All this has been used for the specific kind of substances. Okay, so you have to know that what kind of substance you have to use and which technique it will be preferable for that kind of substance. Okay, so like last class we have covered till here plasmapheresis. So that day I was just discussing with that this plasmapheresis, like nothing but what you have recent one, that for plasma therapy for COVID-19, like you have heard of in the news recently many of times, that many of patients, those who are recovered from the COVID-19, doctors are asking them to share their or contribute the plasma, because whatever antibody they have generated, okay, so due to that generation of antibody, it will be help in that patient, those who are on treatment, it may be helpful. So this is what this plasmapheresis technique. Okay, so next we'll go for the next technique is exchange transfusion. Okay, so it is nothing but it will be having the process of remove of quantity or one specific quantity of blood from a poison patient, and it can be replaced with the identical quantity of whole blood. Means some of the patient who receive who consume poison, so you can remove that poison with the help with this kind of therapy, and you can replace with the same kind of blood. Okay, and in how much quantity you have excreted, that much quantity you can again give that process. And this process usually require 2 to 3 times. You have to repeat this process, like how it, the process of hemodialysis. Hemodialysis is nothing but it will be purifying with the help of some of the labile agent. But here you will just removing the blood, and the same blood you are fresh blood you are infusing in the poison patient. For example, certain conditions like methemoglobinemia, sulfahemoglobinemia, like which are nothing but secondary to the hydrogen sulfide exposure, or sometime in the neonatal drug toxicity. For them, it will be a preferred technique. The next technique will be known as hyperbaric oxygen. It is nothing but it consists of one type of chamber. Okay, indeed you have like certain amount of oxygen which will be supplied to the blood, and there we apply in the form of pressure. Okay, so this called as a pressure chamber. So what is this application? It will increase the amount of oxygen in the blood. So the air pressure which will be inside a hyperbaric oxygen chamber, it will be a 2.5 times greater than the normal pressure in the atmosphere. So what will happen if it is more than, so it will help the blood to carry more oxygen to the different organ and tissue to your body. Okay, then you have chelation therapy. So chelation therapy is mainly used for the administration of chelation agent will be helpful to remove the heavy metals from the body. For example, heavy metals certain like lead, arsenic or mercury with the help of some of the chelating agent like dimercaptosuccinic acid and alpha lipoic acid. Okay, so as you know, like for example, we have seen that tetracycline and milk. Okay, so this is like preferable when you are taking the tetracycline capsule, you should not drink the milk because it may form the chelate complex. Okay, so that could be an adverse event. Okay, but here in some cases when you have consumption of this kind of heavy metal like lead, arsenic or any kind of mercury, so that time what will happen, this chelating agent will be helpful to bind this heavy metal together and eliminate from the body. Okay, so sometime it could be a beneficial also. Okay, the next technique you have cerebrospinal fluid removal. Okay, nothing but it will be useful when any person who poisons, so their cerebrospinal fluid will remove and collect and sample will be collected and then again they will be transfused when it will be removal of poison in the in vivo, means outside of the body. And then last one, which is the latest one we are or in the trend, like which is known as immunological therapy. Okay, so immunological therapy, nothing but where you use antibodies in the certain diagnosis and the treatment of drug poisoning. Okay, and nowadays it is become one of the most common or important aspect in the emergency Medicare. Okay, so for example, I have shared here digoxin specific antibodies, okay, which will be helpful in the toxicity arise due to the digitalis glycoside. So this antibody will go and bind to that particular antigen and they will drive off that effect of the poisons. Okay, so these are the some of the common therapy which will be or approaches or you can say techniques which will be used to increase the elimination enhancement, okay, or to remove the substance from the body. Okay, so here with this toxicokinetic chapter is going to over. Okay, so now elimination enhancement chapter is going to over. So now in respect of this chapter, if you have any question, you can ask. Otherwise, I'll move to the next one. Any question? Come on, guys.
No, sir.
No. Okay. Okay, so next we'll start with the next unit. Again, a very small chapter because you have the basic of that chapter already in your pharmacology. Okay, nothing but your chapter name is toxicokinetic, new one. Okay, so it will be same as your pharmacokinetic. It is purely based upon that chapter. So today I will go and revise that one. Okay, like what are the different process you have there, because both are similarity. One is pharmacokinetic, one is toxicokinetic. At one place your drugs absorption, distribution, metabolism and excretion study will deal, and one place how the poison substance will absorb, distribute, metabolism and excrete. Okay, so for that, before you go to know that about the how it will be known, so we'll go for the this one, pharmacokinetics. Okay, so I'll just share the screen. Are you able to see? Okay. See.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Midun, you take attendance. Okay. Now I think maximum is there.
Okay, sir.
Okay. Now you can see like pharmacokinetic. Here I'll just give you the briefly introduction about the pharmacokinetic. I know you guys must study and you know about this thing. Just a little glance because we proceed toward the toxicokinetic, so you should understand better in the way like how the approach is, because both having the same approaches, only thing here drug, there is a poison substance. Okay, so we'll start with like what you are going to study in that mechanism and principles of absorption, distribution, metabolism and excretion of drug, and it is a one of the basic concept of the pharmacology. Okay. So whenever you are studying any kind of like regarding drug, you should know about its pharmacology. So in that you should know about the pharmacokinetics. Okay. So at the end of this chapter, you will able to know that explain the absorption, distribution, metabolism and excretion and the related mechanism. See how this pharmacokinetics will start. Okay. Okay. So here you can see a simple flow chart. Okay, when any kind of drug which will be administered, it will reach to the drug concentration in the systemic circulation. Till that process is known as absorption. Okay, from like suppose you are taking any drug from oral route, from mouth until it reach to the systemic circulation, till then it will be known as absorption. Okay. Once drug reaches to the systemic circulation, then it is going to the different tissues, like where it need to be get distributed. That process is known as distribution. Okay. Once the drug get distributed and how it is going to metabolize, like you have two kind of phase, phase one and phase two biotransformation reaction. Okay. So that will be there for different kind of substance. Like in phase one you have different reaction, in phase two you have again different reaction. Okay, so all these thing process will take place there. Okay, and finally which kind of substance you have taken, depending upon that it may got eliminated from the different route. Like suppose you have some of the lipid soluble drug, okay, or you can say lipid drug. So for that drug the best secretion or elimination is the biliary secretion. Okay, and some of the drug which is the weak ionized or weak bases, that drug will be eliminated via the renal, okay, or kidney excretion. Okay, so this is what will happen in the process. Okay, this is what you known as the pharmacokinetic process. Okay. The second like is that pharmacodynamic. Like once your drug is fully metabolized, absorbed and distributed, then it drug will reach to go and bind to the its targeted receptor, and it may show or it exert its pharmacological effect, and simultaneously sometime it will also show the clinical response. Nothing but either it may show its efficacy or safety, and second time it may show toxicity. Okay, if drug is more actively, or yeah, you can say there will be a drug-drug interaction will be there if simultaneous or concurrently you have taken two drugs. So all these drug will effect will be seen here. See how drug, see you can see again in the pharmacokinetic of a drug. See drug will go and absorb into the either into the stomach or into the small intestine or large intestine, depending upon the is pH or acidity, all those things. Okay, once drug get absorbed into the dead respective organ, then it will go and get distributed into the systemic circulation as nothing but in the bloodstream. Okay, once that drug get distributed, then metabolize into their primary organ like liver and all those things. From there it may go excreted depending upon the is solubility. Okay, like either it will go through the liver, biliary secretion, kidney excretion. Sometime what will happen, some of the drug like topical application will be there, and sometime it may go via the salivary excretion. Okay, so all these different processes will take place. See absorption, nothing but systematically administered drug to produce pharmacological effect. It must first absorb into the systemic circulation, leave vascular space and enter the intra and intercellular space. Okay, so whenever you are taking any kind of dosage form, okay, it could be oral or any kind of, they must first go and absorb systemically to produce its pharmacological effect. Okay, and then it must go and absorb into the systemic circulation. And there you may have some like sometime what will happen, oral dosage form. Okay, you know that oral dosage form having the one of the disadvantage that they may undergo first pass hepatic metabolism. Okay, so So due to this, what will happen? Whatever amount of drug should reach for the metabolism, it may not reach to that much extent, and it will having the less drug to the bind to the receptor. So therefore, what will happen? You may require more amount or like more doses of the drug to elicit its pharmacological effect. Okay, see, that is, drug must enter bloodstream and reach the site of action. Okay, absorption is the passage of drug from the site of administration into the blood. Okay, so a drug is said to be absorbed only when it enters into the blood or lymph capillaries. Obviously, because as we seen in the last chapter in the elimination enhancement, if you remember, like lymph is one of the part which is known as garbage collector. Okay, so where all drugs will come and get collect and get distributed. Okay, so initially lines of this slide all will be saying that a drug first absorb into the systemic circulation. Systemic nothing but blood and lymph capillaries. So what could be the hurdles for the absorption? One could be the plasma membrane, and other could be a physiochemical nature of drug. Okay, so these two hurdles will be there for all kind of drug, but every time for all hurdles you have solution also. Okay, so we'll see. Okay, here is the solution. See, absorption. Okay, partition coefficient of the drug, the relative affinity of a drug for aqueous and lipid phase matter. Okay, so as you know, like some drug will be having the hydrophilic, or some drug will be having the lipophilic, or you can also call hydrophobic or lipophobic. Okay, so depending upon the nature of a drug may go and release and go and bind to their receptor. Okay, so like, you know, one of the best example, you can say anti-Parkinsonism drug, where you know about the levodopa and carbidopa. Okay, so among them, one drug will be having the potent anti-Parkinsonism activity, but that drug could not cross the blood-brain barrier. Therefore, what will happen? 95% of a drug will eliminate it before it will reach to the target site. Only 5% drug will reach to the target site. So therefore, one drug which is known as a prodrug. Okay, so that will be also given along with that, and it will increase the permeability of another drug to reach to the maximum at a target site. Okay, so this is what will shown into that effect. Okay, the second thing, degree of ionization. Okay, in that, what will happen? In turn affecting the plasma concentration of a drug, which will again affect the drug's ability to diffuse through plasma membrane, like how much drug will be in ionized form and unionized form. Okay, so this both ionized and unionized will play a matter. It will also depend upon the pH. Okay, at what pH, like you know about that, like weakly acidic drug will be there, which are more unionized in the stomach and intestine, but slightly ionized in the plasma. The second, same thing, like weakly basic drug, which are the most highly ionized in the stomach, but largely unionized in the plasma and intestinal lumen. Okay, so therefore, whichever kind of drug, like you have some of the weakly acidic drug, which will be like more absorbed into the here in the stomach. Okay, and they will be eliminated through the weak basic urine. Okay, the same thing, weakly basic drug, they are more ionized into the here in the stomach, so and they will be eliminated through the urine in the form of weakly acidic drug. Okay, this is how they will be proceed. See, there are, you also know that there are different mechanism of this absorption, like passive diffusion, active diffusion, phagocytosis, endocytosis. Okay, so all this will be again play a key role here. See, what is the, like I'm just going to discuss little. See, passive diffusion nothing but where you have passage down the gradient. It will again depend upon the low weight plasma concentration rather than lipid or water solubility. An unionized form of drugs are easily diffused. For example, barbitone, unionized at physiological pH, but it is low weight, plasma concentration is poor, therefore diffusion is slow and slow onset of action. So always this barbitone, like if you know, one of the best example is that phenytoin sodium. Okay, so phenytoin sodium is always advisable to taken into a night, okay, when you are going to into a bed. Okay, this will be majorly used for the seizure. Okay, so what will happen, that only one drug will be advisable when you are going to on bed. Okay, and this drug may show the its effects till the next night when you are taking the tablet, like 24 hours drug effect you are seeing. So it is because their diffusion is slow, okay, and therefore they may show the slow onset and longer period of action. Okay, slow onset, you will not see its effect immediately, but slowly slowly it will show, but it will be having the prolonged duration of action. Okay, therefore this kind of mechanism will be useful for that particular drug. Then you have non electrolyte, unionized form, weak acid and weak basic drug are the most useful drug which will be transported through this mechanism. Then you have filtration. Okay, so pressure gradient and size of pore and corresponding size of the drug influence the rate of filtration. Small water soluble passes easily across aqueous channels on the membrane. Only molecular which are like 100 Armstrong unit easily filter, like urea and ethylene glycol. So again, filtration is also important step, like as we have seen in the elimination enhancement, like some of the drug which are having the molecular weight is more than 50,000 Dalton. Okay, for that you have different process, and might be you have performed this kind of filtration experiment in your pharmaceutics, either in pharmaceutic or biopharmaceutic or any kind of pharmaceutic subject, where you can see a very fine powder will be there. They are easily filtered through a small pore size filter paper only, like where like you have, we have Wattman paper or gradient filter paper. Okay, so you can see they are easily filtered down from that. Okay, and when you are pouring on the same filter paper like large pore size powder or coarse powder or any kind of powder, you can see all material will remain on the filter paper. They will not easily get filtered. This is how this process will be take place. Whenever if any kind of drug will be there, or depending upon the condition, if they like if their pore size is more, then again it will be difficult. When there is a pore size small, like urea and ethylene glycol, that kind of molecule can be easily filtered. Okay, the third process in this, bulk flow. Okay, bulk flow occurs through the intercellular pores within cellular membrane. Okay, and major mechanism of drug absorption via capillary endothelium membrane except in CNS. Okay, why there is a except in CNS? Because there is one barrier will come which is known as blood brain barrier. Okay, therefore it is difficult for this kind of drug which will be crossed through the blood brain barrier, and apart from this like this mechanism will not implement for that kind of drug which we have seen in the first one, passive diffusion. Then you have facilitated diffusion. Okay, this will be mainly based upon the concentration gradient, higher to lower. Okay, and this is one of the a protein carrier mediated transport, and there will be no require of any energy, and characterized by saturability due to limited number of carrier molecule and selectivity, only a particular type, not all. Okay, so we can overcome from that last processes like bulk flow or filtration one. Here we can overcome from this process, like in facilitated diffusion, what will happen, it is only specifically protein carrier mediated transport. Okay, so as you guys know, protein are high molecular weight complex molecule. Okay, so therefore if such kind of process will be take place, so always we require this kind of diffusion process only. Okay, So therefore, any kind of protein molecule, they will undergo this facilitated diffusion. And on first line only saying that there will be a transportation due to the concentration gradient, okay, higher to lower. Then fifth one you have ion pair transport, okay, which are nothing but highly ionized compound, quaternary compound like lipophilic drug, reversibly bind with endogenous chemical like mucin in the GIT lumen, forming a neutral ion pair complex. This complex penetrates the lipid membrane by passive diffusion. Okay, so it will be beneficial for such kind of compound which are having the highly ionized, okay, or quaternary ammonium compound you can say, and sometimes you can say lipophilic drug. They will reversibly bind with the endogenous chemical like mucin, which will be present into your GI lumen, and there they binding and forming a one pair complex which is a neutral, okay, and this complex will help in the penetration of lipid membrane by the passive diffusion. So here you can see in ion pair transport there are two processes are taking place simultaneously, okay. One process will be a itself ion pair and one place by the passive diffusion. Then you have the next one is active transport, okay. So these are nothing but is dependent upon the energy dependent, like earlier slide you have seen in the facilitated one that there is no require of energy, but here you can see there is a require of the energy, okay, and they are carrier mediated transport across the membrane against the concentration gradient. In facilitated we have seen they are transported through the concentrated gradient from higher to lower, and here they are transporting against it, okay, so totally ulta from that facilitated diffusion, okay, and they are stronger chemical resemblance with endogenous chemical, okay, like sugar, nucleic acid, amino acid, and they can highly and easily transported, okay, and they binds to carrier molecule and are transported across the plasma membrane or cell membrane, okay. Unidirectional, saturability, antagonizable, and selectivity, and can be limited by supply of ATP, okay. So example is levodopa used, okay. So as we seen in the first one, like passive diffusion, where I given the example of this one, levodopa and carbidopa, the same thing here they will also take place or it can be passed through the active transport also. And co-administration of structurally similar compound is likely to antagonize or block the transport, okay. So what you can understand by this antagonize, please, if you know about agonist, antagonist, affinity, partial affinity, partial agonist, guys, sleeping.
Sir, something.
Sorry.
This is opposite the action.
Opposite.
Antagonist the action. Means which opposes the action.
Antagonize means nothing but opposite to action, correct, but it will completely block the action of one drug, okay. See, might be you have performed the one of the simulated experiment or just explanation in your pharmacology too, that one maybe you have done PTJ induced sleeping time, have you done?
No, sir.
No, see, in that experiment what will happen with the help of enzyme inducer and enzyme inhibitor, remember or no? Okay, in that okay, I'll tell you. In that experiment what you perform, see, in that experiment what will happen, one of the drugs, for example two drug is there, okay, one is that phenobarbital and another other one is this one, cetirizine, okay. So what will happen, one is you are giving phenobarbital for 5 days to one group of animal and cetirizine to one group of animal, okay? And 6 day, okay, you are giving this phenobarbital separately, okay, apart from the already given, other than that you are giving again phenobarbital to the phenobarbital group and cetirizine group, same this phenobarbital, okay? So what will happen in that first one where you are already given phenobarbital and again you are giving phenobarbital to that particular group of the animal, okay? So what will happen, they may they will having the agonist action, okay? They will show the effect faster, like 5 days animal got sleep in the 15 minutes after taking phenobarbital single dose, okay? On 6 day double dose of phenobarbital may increase in the sleeping time, like it may take only 5 to 7 minutes to get the sleep to the animal, okay? The another group of animals, cetirizine one, okay, they are going to sleep in the 20 minutes, okay? But when you are giving phenobarbital, so what will happen, cetirizine will antagonize the effect of the phenobarbital, so it may again increase the, or sorry, it may again delay the sleeping time, okay? So 20 minutes already they are sleeping, so it may take now 30 minutes or 35 minutes, okay? So this is how they are antagonizing, okay? This is how you can understand the difference between the agonist and antagonist, okay? Sometime you may take some drug like I'll give you one of the best example is cetirizine, okay? Cetirizine tablet is always advisable to take in a calm and relaxed environment or while you are going to bed. It will show the is more agonist effect, okay? You try this, if someone or having allergic or any time cold or anything, when you take cetirizine and you are going to bed for sleep, it may show a very good effect. But the same thing if you are taking the cetirizine and you are roaming in the market or you are watching TV or anywhere you are going out, it may not show that kind of effect, okay? So therefore, to overcome this kind of disadvantage, new drug came, that is called as levocetirizine, okay? Just modified version. So levocetirizine, whenever you take, it will be a helpful, okay? It will be not like that if you are taking into a calm environment or when you are going to bed, it may show the effect, okay? It may show effect anytime, that levocetirizine, okay? But when you are taking cetirizine, you must not, if you are taking, you go to sleep and one time you see, you take the tablet and you roam out. So both time you will see the different effect of that same drug, okay? This is how it could be a agonist or antagonizing of the effect of a drug. And then you have that endocytosis, okay? So cellular uptake of exogenous molecule complex inside plasma membrane derived vesicle, okay? So there what will happen, drug will bind with the vesicle and transport it either by the phagocytotic process or absorption mechanism by binding to the membrane surface, okay? As you know, phagocytotic nothing but self-engulfment, okay? Self-eating or absorption nothing but they are going to bind and absorbing that to the particular surface only, and they are not allowing to drug to move beyond that particular surface, okay? And sometime it may go and take the process with the help of fluid or pinocytotic, where the drug enters the cell as a part of fluid phase, okay? So these are the 7 basic transport mechanism of the absorption, okay? Any doubt you have till here?
No, sir.
Only you are just saying no, other people are sleeping, huh?
No, sir.
No, sir.
Okay, no, yes, doubt. Take. Okay, then no problem. Okay, I'll stop here. We'll continue in the next class. Okay?
Thank you, sir.
Okay, you took attendance, Mithun?
Okay, sir. Yes, sir.
Please share me on WhatsApp, okay?
Okay,
thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.